Coming from the top of the mountain, the man called Cassius Clay is back again, you know. Bobbing and weaving and moving away, the man called Cassius Clay is the order of the day. So if you want to see some...
Yeah, how would I describe himself? Like human, like trying to do things, I suppose, with like energy, trying to flow towards positive things, I guess, the aim of trying to do positive, but obviously get lost along the way and things like, you know, for years it was mostly just drawing coloured pencils and that. It's probably end of secondary school where I just started getting into paints. Started seeing art, amazing paintings, and then I was like, oh, I want to make stuff like that, and that's the way you do it sort of thing, you know. I say Roger Dean's work a lot and Crayola's work, say his paintings really made me want to, I was like, I want to paint like that, that's what I want to learn to do. But a lot of them did street stuff as well, so I was like, well, I want to do street stuff as well. So I mean, that sort of made me feel like, you know, I've got to try spray paint. My street stuff I see is more sort of symbolic, illustrative sort of work, I guess. Definitely over surreal nature to an extent, but that's just the way that styles that are needed to portray what I'm trying to portray, I guess. Good having a good old spinny chair thing, so you can have canvases around, you can do a bit. Like, the thing is, my attention span's awful, so I paint a bit, get into painting, and I get annoyed, and then so it's like, oh, no, jump onto another one, and then do that for a bit. Because I might even do, like, literally 2 minutes on one painting, and be like, all right, yeah, no, and then do a few hours on another one. When I sort of got this energy and feel proper inspired, get sort of feeling, it's like, whoa, the world feels all together, and it's like, oh, on a mad one, rather than other times it feels really slow and methodical. But sometimes I'll be doing sort of detailed stuff and I'm feeling slow and sluggish. And I'll sort of listen to sort of slow music, sort of that. And then other paints when I want to work more lucid than that's when I'll sort of get my spray paints out and the acrylics and back on the old jungle and go. Sometimes I think the whole thing of, well, what are we doing on here, on Earth? We do whatever we do, whether we have control of it or not, like stuff just comes out. You know, so I just have ideas or sort of something will come to me and I'll just be, oh, I need to get that down, you know, scribble it in a sketch or something, and then it might stay there, or it might form into a painting or something. Other ideas are just like, I need to paint, and then just blah, 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 and something jumps out, and then that might go somewhere else for a bit. Jump back to it with an idea, or I'll see something in that and be like, oh, could I add that in there? This, Bristol's definitely had an influence. Well, that's why I sort of came here, sort of thing. All the things I saw, you know, I used to look online, look up art and things. You know, I remember like one night stumbling out of Lakota, coming across like Freedom's work and things, just thinking, what? There's so many artists doing their own things. Everyone's bouncing off each other. And I wish I didn't paint because it's such an annoying thing. As you know, some other jobs, you just sort of do it and then you put it to bed. But yeah, as long as I can get by and a bit of a jolly along the way and eat and paint, yeah. You know, it's just letting go sort of thing, and I suppose that's always what I like, you know, I like doing some paintings. It's just like, oh, fuck it, let's go have fun, like sort of thing. I just want to paint. Yeah, like, not taking things too seriously, just, yeah.